Well, a decades-old photo that turned up after a shopping trip last night. We asked for your help identifying the woman and who the photo might belong to. Tonight, we're getting some answers, but still many questions remain. Jess Fernandez tells us her mother found the old photo stuck to the bottom of an Otter Pops box that she purchased from the Kaimuki Walmart store Saturday night. Fernandez took to the internet to try to find who the woman in the photo might be, but to no avail, so she turned to us.
I would want to have this picture back if it was mine. I would, I mean, sentimental value. It has to be to someone.
Well, after the story aired, we got a lot of leads, and tonight we finally know who the mystery woman is from this 1947 photo. Bridget Namata spoke to her family in a story you'll see only on KHON2.
Lucy, as she's affectionately called by the family who found the photo, isn't her name, but it's close.
Her name's not Lucy. Her name is Lillian Uchiyama.
After our story aired, a woman on Maui emailed us saying the mystery photo looked a lot like her mother, who graduated from Kaimuki in 1947.
When we saw the 1947 on the picture, she was born in 1929, so I knew that must have been a senior picture from high school.
So I went to Kaimuki High School and flipped through the pages of the 1947 yearbook. Sure enough, Lillian H. Uchiyama and the exact same photo found on the bottom of the Ice Pops box. Jan tells me Lillian married, changed her last name to Sanahira, became an Air Force mom to her two kids and grandchildren. That's one mystery solved, but another remains.
How that picture got there, I have no idea.
Lillian passed away in 2013. The timing of this mystery...
And that's the part that is so... I guess it was kind of heart-wrenching, because in about a week is when her passing anniversary is. And it was, and so I've been thinking about her a lot, and then there is her picture on the television.
As she waits for answers, Jan wants to meet the family who found her mom's photo.
That's going to be a real touching moment, I think, to finally get to meet her and to get the photo back.
I reached out to Walmart to see if there was any kind of surveillance video that might show who left the photo behind. I'm still waiting for answers. I'll let you know what I find out. Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.